Shepard Ambellas Show. What's up? All right. That's a little clip from my album Gangstalker 2.0. You can find the link in the link tree in the description below. Just click that link. Also, don't forget to support the broadcast. Very important to support the show. If you want to see video more, you can support the broadcast. I didn't really get that much support this month. I've been working on that website, the new squawk.com. And it's coming along well. That's S-Q-A-U-K. So S-Q-A-U-K.com. You can go there and check it out. It's not quite ready for public launch, but it's getting there and it's looking good. And I appreciate all of you. What's up, Pam? What's up, everyone tuning in? Hopefully some people get in here. I didn't share this out yet. I'm going to try to share it out during the broadcast. But hopefully, anyone that's tuning in later to the restream or whatever, I appreciate all the listeners. Especially all of everyone who tunes in at the YouTube chat. That's really the place to go. And then, of course, the show archives on Apple Podcasts and Spotify shortly after, and all of your other favorite podcast platforms. Please support the show. I virtually got no support for this month, and I got to get some more in. So if anyone can, Arthur, awesome. I just saw some support come through on the Cash App. That's a good way to do it, guys. Arthur, I want to thank you very much. And anyone else who's supported the show over the years, it's been over a decade since I started doing shows. About, 15 years now, since 2009. I started doing shows on American Freedom Radio and on YouTube. And so this is, we're 15 years into it. They've taken down my websites. I got the new squawk.com, S-Q-A-U-K.com. Go there, check it out. It has some, starter content. Things are going to get really cool over there right now. During the solar eclipse, there was people that filmed the moon out, which means that something else was eclipsing the sun, which we were speculating on the Shepard Ambellas Show. A lot of people think it was not the moon. There was also some other huge planets visible in a lot of videos. And it's rather strange. Some people even saw the shadow of a dragon, and I thought that was interesting as well. But one of the most interesting things was how I had speculated early on that the eclipse path was some type of asteroid path that it could land in. They were preparing to use the DART impactor on what I thought was Apophis, because they they essentially called the mission Apophis, and they tried to hide that from the media. Now, what's crazy about all this is an asteroid was filmed burning into the atmosphere at the same time as the eclipse. This is on video. This is on the at Shepard Ambellas Twitter feed. You can see this. Just scroll down several, you know, three, four, five spots down on the Twitter feed and watch some of these videos from the eclipse, and keep a close eye out to the left of the sun right there, and you will see an actual asteroid. It's not the Devil Comet like the guy was speculating. You can see debris and flame shooting off of this. It's clearly inside the Earth's atmosphere. So there is that going on. And, you know, part of that prediction that I was able to make, like that they were worried about an asteroid, was the government has been acting suspicious. They've been acting a lot like when we had the 40 asteroid convergence back during the pandemic phase. And that's primarily what my film Shackled to Silence is all about. And you can find that link in the description. Just click that top link. Takes you to my link tree. You can find all the links there. Get the Shackled to Silence DVD. Become a subscribestar.com/Shep member. And if you do, you can watch all of my films there, feature films, and get the exclusive show that airs every Tuesday. So only on subscribestar.com/Shep. Click that link in the description. Also buy my CD Gangstalker 2.0 if you like to listen to beats while you're driving, stuff like that. That's pretty cool, and you can support the show. I have some of those left as well. Get your physical DVDs of Shackled to Silence. And I appreciate everyone for tuning in. What's up, Wayne, Art, Pam, Rusty? Good to see you guys. Siren, Abe, lots of crazy stuff going on. You know, part of this is getting weird because I had spoken about earthquakes on the show and the possibility of earthquakes around the New Madrid area or other areas. And there was three earthquakes leading up to the solar eclipse. We talked about how there was heavy earthquakes back in, I think, 1775 or 76. And also lots of towns were rubbled back then. And it makes me wonder, because they say that's when this last eclipse that was similar to this happened. But now they're saying, out of live science, that part of the San Andreas Fault may be gearing up for an earthquake. The park-filled section of the San Andreas Fault is sending mixed messages before a time of expected increased seismic risk. And I mean, this doesn't come at a more crucial time. We talked about this perturber moving in. Now, potentially Planet X has been spotted aside from the solar eclipse. The moon spotted separately. I mean, this is very bizarre times we're living in. A lot of people think this is biblical. This is the end times. Now, this article is talking about a section of the San Andreas Fault where earthquakes occur regularly may give off a distinct signal before it trembles to life, new research finds. The signal hints at the opening and closing of cracks beneath the surface. Now, they are saying that this fault line is the park-filled Central California fault, and it shakes about every 22 years. This last ruptured in 2004, and they're saying an earthquake is imminent. And the Metro's reporting the same thing. They are saying that it literally is hinting at a quake. They got a map in here. It's showing Parkfield, Santa Barbara, Los Angeles, Palm Springs, San Diego. They are literally acting like this fault is going to come unzipped, and scientists are always eagerly studying it. They are definitely always looking into this famous fault line, and this is in the Golden State of California, of course. We all know about this, the San Andreas Fault. It's been heavily reported on over the years, but now something is starting to happen. And you know, guys, go to the Squawk Twitter, follow it at Squawk _. It's at SQAUK _. SQAUK _. Follow that on Twitter, search it out. So on my Twitter, the Shepard Ambellas Twitter, I put, YouTube has been censoring my subscribers and has been for years. And, this post got flagged by a content warning. I put, this month I had 224,200 watch minutes on my channel, and I gained not one subscriber as usual. I have documented this over the years. Any attorneys want to take the case? And Twitter put a sensitive warning content on this. And you have to click through it to see that I gained zero subscribers. And I have 224,200 watch minutes just this month. Every month I gained zero subscribers for the last decade. But yet, I don't know. It's crazy. So I've never gained a subscriber in like a decade, pretty much. Below that, there was, there's a video. It says, I was right. An asteroid was threatening to impact the day of the eclipse. We are in continuity of government and Planet X is nearby. And in this, you can see the video of this comet and you can see how massive it was and how truly close it came, and it looks like they actually activated planetary defense measures or something. They talked about the DART impactor. They talked about this mission Apophis, and I find this very odd. This correlated with a dream I had about 3-4 years ago. Very suspicious. I had a dream where an asteroid crashed into the earth. It scathed across the earth at a extreme angle and kind of just dug a trench across it down near Mexico and Arizona. And it did so in the angle of the path of totality. This event was supposed to happen, but it looks like, who knows, maybe they ran a deflection mission. They openly were stating they were firing the DART impactor rockets at it, but they were trying to cover up some of this news about it, and I find it odd. Guys, America is falling apart. It is just a pile of garbage now. Yahoo Finance is reporting that a $1,400 SUV payment, a $1,600 truck payment sounds absurd, but it's becoming more common. And this Yahoo Finance, they're saying a TikTok user who goes by the name of Blasey Arnold says she has two massive car payments every month. One for her Chevy Tahoe SUV, which she financed for $84,000 at 10% interest rate, and the other for her husband's GMC Sierra 1500 AT4 pickup truck financed for $78,000 at 14%. And the total payment on her Tahoe is $1,400 a month. The Sierra payment, $1,600 a month. These people have to pay that just to drive themselves to work. I mean, people have lost it. I don't do any of that anymore. I can't even afford to walk, basically. And I can't afford to eat or drink water, in a bottle. And, I can't afford the video for the StreamYard. And these guys are paying $1,400 and $1,600 for two vehicles. And that's before they even pay for gas and drive themselves to work. And they do that just to become slaves at their jobs. Yes. And they become slaves at those jobs. And then they pay all of that out. And everyone else gets their hands on your money before you do. And that's how America's built. And it's going bankrupt. And now the FBI is saying China is actually threatening hackers. That, you know, they're saying these hackers can wreak havoc. And they're saying this could happen anywhere in the U.S. It's a matter of national security. And of course, this is like the rhetoric that they had back during the missile crisis, the Cuban missile crisis, the Cold War era as well. And they're saying that cyber agents and these so-called intelligence analysts, they're focused on this threat from China. And they're saying that Americans better watch out, basically, you know? Guys, it's getting crazy. Gas prices are out of control. Food prices out of control. They're spraying everything. They're poisoning everything. Car payments out of control. $1,400, $1,600 per month. Rent in cities, $2,000 a month, $2,500 a month. In Hawaii, $4,000, $8,000 a month. Alaska, Hawaii, milk, $20 a gallon, $10 a gallon. California spent billions on homelessness without tracking if it even worked. And they're still homeless everywhere, and they probably just spent the money doing nothing. They probably never even gave the homeless any of that money. This is how ridiculous it is. So, YouTube removes Joker 2 warning from trailer. YouTube on Wednesday removed a warning that the Joker 2 trailer may include suicide or self-harm topics. A rep for the video platform says systems had incorrectly applied the warning label. We determined that our systems applied the warning interstitial incorrectly, a YouTube spokesperson told Variety. The trailer remains available on YouTube without warning. You know, in what day and age and era are we living in? I mean, this is insane, to where everything is censored, everything is micromanaged. Every facet of your life is micromanaged. It's as if they, you know, I don't even know. We got open lines, 262-891-0070. What's up? You're on the air. This is Shepard. Who's this?
Yeah, this is Steve. I'm just calling to tell you about your extended warranty on your car. You know, you need to renew it.
What's up, man? How you been?
I've been all right. How you been, buddy?
Oh, you know, just watching everything fall apart. They got $1,400 car payments, $2,000 rent payments now. Food and water is super expensive. I mean, I guess everyone needs to start raising their own chickens.
That's what I've been doing this past year and some change, making my own chickens.
That's awesome. I love chickens, man. How they operate and everything. Did you been getting any eggs out of them?
Yeah, I've gotten a whole bunch of eggs out of them, and then I'm raising chicks right now and selling them.
Really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Are a lot of people responding well? Like, are they wanting
them?
Yeah,
actually, the first batch of chicks that I sold, I had two people wanting them. And then, of course, I made the agreement with the first person. And then I found out who she was, and I didn't particularly care for that. It was the sheriff's wife.
How was your eclipse, man? What did you see anything?
I looked at it. It was really cloudy, but the clouds actually helped. So you could actually like see it without using those, you know, sun worshiping glasses.
Yeah, I tried to look at it, but I burnt my eyeballs out. Now all I see is dark black.
I got a couple of good pictures out of it. My woman got a really good picture out of it. Just using her, you know, because she's got one of those friggin' like massive cameras. Because she does like photography here and there.
Yeah.
But she got a really nice picture of it. What do you think about them damn earthquakes? 4.8, right?
Yeah, you know, just lots of earthquake activity.
Remember that number, 4.8. Mm-hmm. When was the eclipse?
4.8.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
And there weren't no damn earthquake in New York. You know that shit. You know what went down? It was the lizard people. They were excavating because they had a good hatching season, so they had to make everything bigger.
What if it's really crazy like that? They got eggs down there, lizard eggs in the underground bases.
Or it might have been the subway rats unionizing.
I wouldn't doubt that. Those things are getting big. I heard they're selling those in New York as food. On the street food.
Yeah, I saw videos like that. Like friggin' the side street friggin' peep vendors or whatever you want to call them.
Oh,
they look
man.
Like fucking rats to me.
Oh, that's crazy.
I'm not eating no rats.
Hell no.
Especially the ones that eat on the homeless people's bodies.
Right. What do you think about these $1,400 and $1,600 a month car payments people are getting?
Didn't you say the $84K was it, what, 5%?
Yeah, and then what? No, 10%, I think, and something. 5% and 10%.
That's insane.
I think it's crazy, though, like the cost of vehicles and stuff, and I don't know. Just everything's like out of control.
You're talking to somebody that drives 50-year-old and 30-year-old vehicles.
Dude, that's so smart, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, it really is. As long as, you know what I mean? That's actually smart.
Yeah. I wouldn't pick anything else. I got to find a new engine for my old pickup truck. The fucking oil pump went out in it and seized the crankshaft.
But at least you can get in there and work on it and shit, too.
Yeah, I could, if it's raining, I could just get in there and close the hood.
Yep.
Keep working. Now I'm driving a little 94 Ford Ranger. It's pretty good. It's a little 5-speed. It's millennial proof.
Oh, that's cool.
Millennials can't drive 5-speed. Yeah,
you can't even get it stolen anymore.
Nope. I can leave the keys in the ignition. Ain't nobody going to take it because they don't know how to drive it. What is this archaic technology?
That's funny, dude.
I think it's funny as hell. And I got the truck for free.
Oh, that's good,
so
dude.
That helped me out.
Yeah, heck yeah. That's the best way. I mean, especially like, dude, in older trucks too. Even remember when vehicles were real though, back in the day, like the 50s, the 60s?
Yeah. See, it's weird because, like, you know, this truck is, you know, 30 years old. Well, you know, let's go back to my other truck. It's 46 years old. It's got a little rust around the wheel well or the on the bed where the rear wheels are at.
Yeah.
But the bed's still solid.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you look at this one here, this, you know, my little 94, it's solid too. So it's 30 years of being outside and in the weather. Well, my dad's got a 87 Ford Ranger that, you know, I wouldn't even think about trying to work on. The whole bed is rotted out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just like, you know, a handful of years older than this one here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, did something change? Was it bad steel from China?
Probably, yep. Chinese. They did it, guaranteed. No. They're going to cancel me now.
The 46-year-old truck was made out of Detroit steel.
Oh, yeah.
So, what's the problem here?
I wonder what they built out of that steel from the World Trade Center that they shipped to China.
God.
Cars.
That's so cringe.
2002 cars.
Oh, my God.
We're all built with that.
We gonna buy all your steel from buildings that kill many, many people. Oh, we like these.
If you guys got a 2002 vehicle, guaranteed it's radioactive.
Guaranteed.
From the micronukes at that World Trade Center core.
Get in one and just take a deep breath. World Trade Center.
Yeah, man.
Holy shit. That's morbid. That's morbidly obese.
So what do you think about, did you hear how that supposed I believe it was FBI agent or CIA. I think he might have been like FBI claiming got caught on camera saying they set up Alex Jones.
Yeah, I saw that the other day.
But, it makes me think that's just like shit they released to try and give credence to Alex Jones because he's CIA too. I don't even believe that shit.
I think it's just smoke and mirrors.
Yeah.
It's clickbait.
Yeah.
I don't believe half of anything I see or read anymore.
I know it's...
Unless it's in regarding like the occult. If it's regarding the occult, I'll read the shit out of that. I'm like, aha, I see now.
Yeah.
Like when you read news articles, if you ever see like, there was 13 people that died or 13 people injured.
They were all 33 years old.
Yeah, they were all 33 years old, but the number 13 is paying homage to the 13 families that actually run the fucking world.
Yeah.
They have to put it in there. It's like, it's that time of the month, buddy. We're going to come after your families if you don't, give us some fucking kudos.
That's what they do, too.
Yes, my master.
It's like how the mafia used to ask for insurance or they'll break your legs,
Yeah. I'll break your kneecap if you don't pay me that $20 protection fee that you owe me for your shitty business.
I was watching some stuff on Puff Daddy, and he's involved in all them lawsuits now and all this stuff, and there's all those allegations that he's basically like the Epstein of rap. And, he was on the Ellen show, and Ellen was asking about his parties, and it looks like she went to him because someone confronted her about it, and she got all weird. So all this stuff's like coming unraveled with these secret parties they got in Hollywood and all this shit.
Oh, yeah. It's all fucking true. You saw the pictures I sent you of that friggin' PBS bullshit. Remember? I think I sent them to you.
What was it? Remind me.
It was Elton John getting an award for something. And don't get me wrong, I like Elton John. One of my buddies used to say when we would carpool, every time an Elton John song would come in, he'd be like, "That fag can sing." I always thought it was funny, but I always liked his music. But seeing what I saw, oh my God, that was bad. And then Metallica got involved with it.
Oh, really? What happened with that?
Yeah.
Why did Metallica get involved?
I had no idea. The only reason that I wanted to watch it was because it was Elton John and Metallica. I was like, shit, that should be a pretty good fucking show. Because I went to a Metallica concert, I want to say it was 2017 in Atlanta at the new Braves Stadium. That was a 6-hour freaking show, and it was totally worth it.
Mm-hmm.
But seeing that, See, what happened was this friggin' trans black man opened up for Metallica, and he was singing "The Bitch Is Back," and he was dressed up in, you know, all these lady clothes and blah blah blah, you know, whatever you want to do, man. And then he started, what pissed me off was he started fucking twerking in Elton John's face.
I bet that was crazy. Like, what the hell?
I'm like, what the fuck? And
oh,
then,
that's,
you know,
nuts.
He gets up on stage.
Yeah.
And then the pictures I took, holy shit. Because there was like, you know, they were talking about this one kid that died in like the 90s from AIDS because his mom had AIDS, and then he was born and he had AIDS. And
yeah,
he died shortly after it. I think they made a movie about it in the 90s. I'm not sure.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
It sounds familiar.
That,
the whole story.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about.
But, so they were talking about this kid, and then all of a sudden the same dude comes back, and he's dressed up with his pair of, like, sunglasses, and he's, like, in, like, a mink coat. And he's walking down the aisle, and there's, when I took this picture, it was priceless because there was two black guys sitting on either side, you know, of the aisle.
Were there
one
any
guy
Chinese?
Up. I didn't see any Chinese.
What about a Mexican?
I think I saw a handful of Mexicans.
No, I'm kidding.
But this one guy is looking up at this guy, and he's like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And then the other black guy is looking, and you can tell that it's pissing him off. He's like, he's upset. He's got that, but he's looking up.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, Metallica takes the stage. Does that mean Metallica's trans now? The trans Metallica Siberian Orchestra?
Oh, man.
Damn.
Pam said in the YouTube
and
chat,
I couldn't watch anymore.
Milk in Alaska is $4.99 a gallon. But Pam, in when I was in Alaska, way out in the Aleutian chain out there in Sandpoint, like, shit, it, I mean, this was back in the day, it was like $19-$20, but I don't know what part of Alaska you're in.
That was cheap.
Yeah, that's cheap.
I'm going to say it was like 10 or 15 years ago, milk in Alaska was like $20 a gallon.
Yeah, that's what it was when I was there. But I was way out on some island.
Because my mother always talked about moving to Alaska. She's like, we need to move to Alaska. And I'd be like, all right, let's go. And then my dad would be like, you know, son, milk's $20 a gallon. Of course, when I was a kid, We would go through like 2 gallons of milk a week.
You would have to start
like
eating
easily.
Just water on your cereal?
Yeah, yeah.
What you got to do to
That's
your cereal now, in America, you got to get those electromagnets or those big U magnets, and you got to run it through your cereal because like huge metal shards come out of
anyway.
That shit.
You know, that's not going to work anyway. Because if you look on a box to say, you know, Captain Crunch or, you know, Frosted Flakes, friggin' what's the other big one? Cinnamon Toast Crunch. You look for an ingredient called TSP. It's trisodium phosphate. It's a cleaning agent. If
oh, that's
eat a
good for you. It cleans your bowels.
But it's good for cereal, right? Yeah.
Dude, that cleans your butthole.
Clean with that shit. It'll clean you
it
out.
It bleaches it.
I'm
I eat Captain Crunch and I got a bleached butthole.
Kellogg. I'm Professor Kellogg. I invented cornflakes to keep mentally insane people from masturbating. But I also put cleaning agent in it, so at least they shit clean.
Oh, shit.
Did you know that? Fun fact.
Man.
Cornflakes was invented for mentally ill people that were masturbating.
Oh, really?
Yes.
That's fucked.
Look it up. The
Damn.
More you know.
I don't trust any cereal. I don't eat that shit. I never ate cornflakes
either,
for the record.
The first thing I do, like if I pick up a bag, you know, say something quick, like a bag of potato chips. All right, let me eat you some potato chips real quick, just because, you know, I need a snack. First thing I do is hit that ingredients label and look for bioengineered food ingredients. And then I'd be like, nope. And then all these people drinking like the Celsius energy drinks and shit like that. They have they all have synthetic B12 in them. You know how you make synthetic B12?
No. What are they doing that out of?
Cyanide.
Oh, shit. A lot of stuff has cyanide in it now.
Yeah, it's cyanide something. I can't remember how it's pronounced.
I think apple seeds have cyanide in it.
Oh, yeah, they have cyanide in them. It's natural. If you take and bite into them,
mm-hmm.
and they taste like almonds. Cyanide tastes like almonds.
I used to eat just bags of apple seeds. No.
I used to do it, too.
No, but I think I have eaten apple seeds.
The whole pit, or the whole core. We ate it all.
Damn.
Why? Because we were poor.
I used to eat lead paint. No, I'm kidding. Howard Stern said that shit. Howard Stern's like, I used to eat lead paint.
Dip them in cheese. I like to dip them in cheese. I like a bucket of cheese. Bucket of cheese.
Yeah, so, shit. I don't know.
Shit.
I wonder what's coming up now, next, in, you know, with the whole sideshow.
With
the sideshow and, you know, with the presidency and everything.
I can't wait.
Yeah,
I can't wait.
Yeah, because they're saying that Biden is ahead of Trump in the polls now.
Yeah, okay, sure.
He has like one guy at a gathering. You put it on a national gathering, you got like one guy. It's that one guy.
No, he's got one guy that sits in his grandmother's basement, and he's surrounded by about 800 or 900 fucking Android cell phones. That's what he's doing.
Heck
and
yeah.
Eating cornflakes so he doesn't masturbate. Giggity.
Well, shit, I wonder what they're going to try before the election. I bet a lot of things will happen between now and the elections and whatnot. But have you noticed there's not been that many debates or anything? Like, isn't there usually?
Yeah.
That's weird.
I have noticed that. Actually, in these past eight years, I have seen less talk about the elections on TV within this last couple of months.
Yeah.
From when Trump was in, they're like, oh my gosh, and then he got out and they're still and then it's Biden, and they're like, but now I'm not seeing a whole lot.
Yeah, I don't know what they're gonna pull. It's awfully quiet though too. Like, it's like the calm before the storm.
Right. I'm on the side that there's not going to be a 2024 election. That something's going to happen. You know, obviously it's going to be something that we did. And there's going to be martial law. So there will not be a presidential election. And then that's it. We're going to be stuck until... it's going to be another 20-year fucking war, like with Afghanistan. Except technically, Iraq war.
Oh shit! What if they do?
Technically, that wasn't 20 years long because, like, after the first handful of years, there wasn't any fighting. We were still over there, but there wasn't any fighting. Why were we still over there if there's not any fighting? Well, my dad would say, well, you can't defeat a country and just leave them to fucking fend it out for themselves. Like, you sure fucking damn can. Look at Germany. They got fucking taxed to death. wheelbarrows full of fucking Reichmarks to fucking buy a loaf of fucking bread. And yeah. we left them alone. And then we put up a wall. Well, we didn't put the wall up. The Russians put the wall up. Mm-hmm. And we came back. But there was no fighting.
I do.
Crazy, huh?
You do what?
I love corn dogs.
You love corn dogs? Good. Go eat your corn dog.
That sounds yeah. good. I like corn dogs with mustard. I like those ones from the fair, though.
With mustard too.
Like a fresh one yeah. would be like really super good.
Well, these are the state fair ones. So
oh, nice, dude.
State fair brand or yeah. however. I don't know. But that's my prediction. Is there not? There's not going to be one. And if there is one, you can count on Big Mike being one of the runner-ups. She's going to be the Democrat pick.
Just Big
boom,
Mike.
Out of the fucking left corner field.
Oh, yeah.
Bam.
Here comes Big Mike.
Big Mike.
Out of nowhere, dressed like a football player. They run her in.
And Barack Obama's going to be like, I knew you missed me.
They run her in a commercial
Chocolate
for
Jesus.
Big Mike, and it's for Michelle Obama, and they dress her like a football player, and they run her in as a linebacker.
I haven't seen that one, but I'm gonna have to. You've got Instagram, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to send you this shit on Instagram. It's fucking hilarious. It's a movie trailer for a movie that's not actually coming out. And the movie's called Big Mike. And it's this guy that, because it starts off with a news reporter saying,
Big Mike.
The cook of President, the private cook of President Barack Obama was found mysteriously dead after a surfing accident. And all of a sudden, this new guy comes to fucking be the cook. And then this woman's like, so. Have you met Michelle yet? He's like, no, I haven't. He's like, you know, she goes, just make sure you have Michelle's steaks ready at 6.
Oh.
And he's like, ooh, what the shit? He's like, what's going on? So he's like in the shower, and then he hears the door close. So he gets fucking out, and there's a note. You can't read what the note says, but it's got like a heart on it.
Mm-hmm.
And he's looking at it. He's like, what the fuck? And then all of a sudden he's walking by the bathroom. And then you see fucking Michelle leaned up against the wall, standing up, pissing with the door open. He's like walking fast. And then all of a sudden he's like in the kitchen and it overlooks like the pool and shit. And you can see Michelle in her dress, like spying on this guy.
That's wild.
And then all of a sudden, you see him like lifting weights. You know, you only see the backside of, you know, Big Mike, Michelle. She's out there lifting fucking weights. And then you hear Barack Obama come up behind the guy. And he's like, Are you admiring, my wife, Michael? I mean, Michelle.
Damn. Did who was that ended up dead? That lady said that she knows Michelle was a trans, and they all do. And then, like, a week later, she ended up dead.
Yeah. I guess Barack is killing people now, because it used to, you know, I didn't like Obama.
Yeah.
I really did not. But I agreed with some of the stuff he did. Not a lot of it. A little bit.
Well, they had him. They had him running a real good campaign too. He would act like real nice, like he's a good person. Everything's great.
Yeah.
But man, he's a real good manipulator.
I'm on the phone. Yeah. But oh shit, what was I gonna say? Crap. There was a couple of things that I agreed with, like the majority of it was a fucking lie. Everything he said was a fucking lie. And I remember getting into a fight with my ex-wife because she was a supposed Democrat. And at the time I was a supposed Republican.
Yeah.
I'm a libertarian now. I feel like you should be able to do whatever the fuck you want to do as long as you're not hurting anybody, and especially hurting kids. hurt kids, you need to get shot in the face. But she's like, oh, well, we can get Obamacare. It's coming up. And I'm like, it's not going to fucking fly. I'm like, it's going to fucking sink. She's like, you don't know that. It takes 8 years of a former president being out of office in order to see the actual good that he did. And I said, all right. I'm like, all right, we'll fucking wait. I'll show you. And then not 2 months later, Obamacare fucking falls through. And I show it to her. And she's like, just shut up.
That Obamacare was shit.
It's not been 8 years. It fucking was.
What about that Michelle Obama school lunches were shit? That was like prison food.
Well, funny thing, you bring up school lunches. Did you know the company that supplies all, we're talking all of the school foods, is the same company that supplies all of the hospital foods to all the patients? And are you ready for this one? Are you ready for the big one? Are you ready? They're the same company that supplies all of the fucking prisons and jails food.
Hmm.
The kids are eating jail food.
Damn. That's fucked.
Yeah.
Plus, you know that's probably Soylent Green and shit. They used to feed us 100%. In this one school I went to. They fucking would give you like a chicken fried steak, right? For one of the days. You couldn't even pick.
Mm-hmm.
I also went to a school in Florida where it was like a fucking food court in a mall and you could get anything because it was like an affluent area and it was like ridiculous. You could have milkshakes and anything you wanted.
We had chicken fried steak.
But dude, this chicken fried steak, bro, it was green and then they put like the gravy was green snot on it to top it off, and the meat was green.
Yeah, we had chicken fried steak when I was in jail.
I was dude, like, did it look like someone blew a snot load on it?
It looked like somebody blew fucking loogie on it.
Oh, dude!
I gave it to the other guy, and then we started playing spades after that. I don't know why is fucking everybody love the game spades in jail. I don't fucking get it. Like, why don't we play something real like gin? Can you play gin? I don't know what gin is, but I can play spades. Okay, we'll play spades since.
Did you ever play drop the soap?
Nope. I did not. There was two showers in my friggin' cell. They called it a pod because it was like general population. So there was like two showers and, you know, it was like being at camp. That's what I felt like. It was at camp that I couldn't leave. I'm going to call my mom and she's going to come get me.
Band camp.
Band camp, yeah. And then at night hearing everybody fucking fart and laugh and giggle. It was just like being at fucking camp. I was like, God damn it. I made one friend while I was in jail. He was kind of like the Birdman. If you were like Shawshank Redemption, he was like the book guy. Like, I need a book. Give me a book.
Did you ever make anyone your bitch maid? You're like, wash my clothes.
No, I was dealing drugs while I was in there, though. This, you know, this is back in the bad me days.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, I was prescribed certain medications that they had to give me.
Mm-hmm.
And I would deal them out. I'd pretend to take it and it was like, here, I'm like, you fucking owe me.
Damn, that's crazy. A lot of shit goes on in jails. Fucking weird shit.
It does.
Dude. And how they run them, and it's all a weird system. I wonder who's the executioner.
I don't, you know, there was this one guy that everybody called Hollywood because he got locked up from charges from Florida because he was living in North Carolina and it was like something to do with computers. And this was like from way, way back, and they fucking found out about, he got pulled over, and they, you know, they caught him. The whole time he's like bragging about how his girl's giving him all this fucking money and shit like this, and they were they were holding him for extradition to Florida. And but everybody called him fucking Hollywood. So here I am sitting on my fucking bunk, and I always sat on the top bunk, because I don't like things being over top of me like that close. And sitting here reading a book, and there was this fucking storm, fucking like a massive lightning storm coming through. And, you know, there's these little windows that were like maybe a foot and a half by friggin' 9 or 10 inches up, and then a foot and a half, little rectangle windows. And he kept getting up there, and it was by my fucking bunk. Mm-hmm. He'd get up there and he'd look through his fucking window, and the fucking, he's like, oh my God, look at that shit. It's going crazy out there. And then one of the fucking guards was like, get off the fucking windows. And he got down. And then all of a sudden it got worse. So he gets back up there. And then all of a sudden, here I am fucking reading this book. And I see they're like, get off the goddamn windows. And I turn and look at him. There's a fucking red dot on the wall, and then it goes to the back of his head.
Oh, shit, he's got a red dot on his head.
I fucking jumped.
Oh, shit, you got a red dot on your head, too. Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
I fucking ran down the stairs. Like, oh, shit, I'm not seeing nobody get dead today. It was fucking crazy. Like, almost watched a guy lose his fucking life.
That's crazy.
I mean, I was in there for gun charges.
Mm-hmm. That's scary if you see a red dot on someone's head or your head. Fuck that.
I ran.
Could have been the predator.
I'm like, see ya. Yeah.
He sees with thermal vision.
I was fucking off. I was gone. I was out of the way. Like, take your shot. Go for it.
Yeah.
It was fucking scary.
This is for all the juggalos out there.
I was in there with the old guy. There was like two or three young guys that were in that spot. The rest of us were like old. But I was in there with fucking murderers and shit.
Damn, that's ruthless.
That was interesting.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
Actually, funny thing, because you sent me that thing about the ICP. I made friends with one of those murderers immediately. Because I saw his fucking juggalo tattoo. And I looked at him. I'm like, what is a juggalo? Let me think for a second. Then we were fucking friends. It was funny as shit.
Yeah, this is
separation.
Can you believe this is the 425th episode of the Shepard Ambellas Show? That's crazy.
Insane. Yeah. In the membrane.
Yeah. Well, I guess I'm going to get out of here, guys. I'll be back on tomorrow. I was working on that website since 3 a.m. If anyone can contribute, please do. I'm struggling pretty hard this month to keep everything going.
I'll see what I can do.
Oh, I appreciate that, Rusty. That's awesome, brother. And I appreciate you calling in as well. It's good to talk to people, you know, and just
it's always good to talk.
Yeah, like I get stuck doing all this website stuff and everything, so pretty cool. Yep. All right, well, I'll be back on tomorrow, and I'll see y'all later. Please support the broadcast. Thanks so much, guys. Have a good one.
Love you.
Thanks to everyone who made a contribution today. Thank you, Pam. Thanks, Art. Rusty, thank you. And there it is, another ticket. How many times will I track kids on crack? You guys should check out Violent J from ICP. Check him out on some interviews. I'll see y'all later. See y'all tomorrow.